Now, my 70s were the difference. As I mentioned, it was a few months ago that we had a very knowledgeable text about 70s music from somebody who said, I'm 14 years of age, which we thought, it's a bit interesting. So we called him up on the air and invited Martin to come into our studios and play some of his favourite 70s stuff, which he did recently. He came in with his mum and dad, Teresa and Stuart. And, you know, we kind of got talking about how amazing it was that someone who completely missed out on the decade should be so knowledgeable of 70s music. Here's Martin.
I was actually born in 1999, so like about 20 years after. Yeah, so, or more, actually.
So how did, was it through your dad?
Yeah, well, my mum and dad both really like 70s music, and what I basically did was I just sort of borrowed their records, and they were actually records, obviously, because it was 70s. Then I just picked the ones I liked and it went on from there, and I just got my own taste in 70s music.
What are you playing these records on?
Well, these days I do actually generally play them, it's not really 70s, on CD, but I do have quite a lot of records, so I do sometimes get the old records out.
Yeah, but I'm just wondering, is it like a little box of a record player?
With the, just a small record player. Yeah.
There was something about vinyl, isn't there?
Yeah, there is something really nice about having the big artwork and all that.
And what do we go to next? The Cure?
Yep. Boys Don't Cry. I'm not actually a massive Cure fan, but this song is really great. It's got such a great riff and everything. It's just really catchy and a really great song.
Secure, Boys Don't Cry, and that's chosen by Martin Leitch, who's doing a sort of My 70s here at Radio 2 this afternoon. Do you ever get to see any 70s bands live?
Well, I have seen Zappa Play Zappa, who are a sort of Frank Zappa tribute band, but that's the closest I've, and he was around in the 70s, but not actually Frank Zappa because he's dead. That's the closest I've got to actually seeing a 70s band live, but thanks to the magic of DVDs, I've seen The Doors live and you know, all those great bands.
Do you have friends that share your enthusiasm, or do they think you're a bit of a weirdo?
Sadly not, no. My friends mainly just like, yeah, modern pop music. I mean, I'm not saying I don't like modern music, because I do, but I'm pretty much the only one that seems to like 70s music. Bit of a shame, but still.
All right, let's move on to Nick Drake next. Amazing talent.
Nick Drake, what a guitarist and what a songwriter. I mean, only did 3 albums, but amazing albums. They're really brilliant, beautiful music. Yeah.
You got all 3 at home?
Yeah. My favourite one is the one that this is off, Pink Moon, but all 3 of them are brilliant.
Okay, yeah. And the song's called?
Parasite.
Seeing the light in a station bar and travelling far and thin, sailing downstairs to the northern line, watching the shine of the shows, hearing the trials of the people there, who's to care if they lose. But take a look, you may see me. Dancing a jig in the church with chimes, a sign of the times today. And hearing no bell from a steeple toll, people all in dismay. Falling so far on a silver spoon, making the moon for fun.
Take a look, you may see me coming through. For I am the parasite who travels two by two. When I'm lifting the mask from a local clown, I'm feeling down like him. And I'm seeing the light in a station bar, I'm traveling far and thin. And I'm sailing downstairs to the northern line, watching the shine of the shoes. And hearing the trials of the people there, who's to care if they lose? Take a look, you may see me. Take a look, you may see me in the dark. For I am the parasite who hangs from your skirt.
Nick Drake and Parasite. It's Radio 2 on a Sunday afternoon, and my guest is Martin Leitch from Bexhill-on-Sea. Punk rock. What did you think of punk rock?
I really like it. I'm generally a fan of the slightly more, I don't know, experimental stuff. Not so much just the three-chord stuff, but something a bit weirder. Punk rock with a weird edge, and Public Image are my sort of favourite punk band, and this track off their first album is wicked.
John Lydon as Public Image Limited and Public Image Limited. That was such a good track, that.
Yeah, definitely.
Crawley, I sometimes used to think, if Peter shut up, it had made a brilliant instrumental.
It would.
Martin Leitch is here, picking records, but you also play music.
Yeah, I do play a bit of music. I'm even in a sort of a small band. Well, I say a band, it's just a duo with my dad, because he plays the guitar as well. But
calling it a band, I think stretching it just a little.
Maybe a little bit, but, well, yeah.
No, I was thinking of a school group. You know,
yeah, no, well, it's not. There's not that many members.
Okay, so what do you play?
I play the drums and the guitar. I'm not so great on the guitar, but I give it a go. And I've got a synthesizer, so I also have a go at that.
Yeah. And what's your dad play?
Guitar.
Yeah. Yeah. Is he any good?
Yeah, he's all right.
All right, next choice.
I think we're going to end on Maggot Brain by Funkadelic, which is just an incredible track. It's really long, but it's every moment is amazing. An incredible guitar solo. I think Eddie Hazel did it. And I think the emotion in there, I think he was told by George Clinton, who was the front man, to imagine that his mother had died, and then he learned that it wasn't true. And that's sort of the emotion behind it, apparently. That's what I read.
I would imagine your parents, Stuart and Teresa, are learning a bit about music from you now. It's probably gone the other way.
I don't know, maybe, yeah.
Well, listen, it's been great to meet you.
Yeah, thank you, you too. Thank you.
Slightly edited version of a 10-minute epic chosen by Martin Leitch, Funkadelic's Maggot Brain. And Martin, many thanks for coming in. It was a great pleasure to meet you and your mum and dad, and continue to enjoy 70s music in the future.